Welcome back. Did you know today is Wisconsin Combat Journalist Day? It marks the 50th anniversary of Dickie Chappelle, the first American female war correspondent killed in action. John Garofalo joins us now, who wrote a very special book about her. And John, she's a very special lady. What can you tell us about her?
Well, Dickie Chappelle was the first American female war correspondent killed in action. And over time, she's been relatively forgotten. And today happens to be the 50th anniversary of her death in Vietnam. And so I think that it's a great opportunity to sort of reflect back and really bring Dickie Chappelle back into our everyday or average American's understanding and knowledge of her as a great hero.
Now, during the commercial break, I was actually thumbing through this book, and some of her photos are up on the screen right now. Tell us, where did she go? What did she see?
She originally started as a war correspondent during World War II, so she did it for quite some time. And during World War II, she ended up on Iwo Jima and Okinawa, which were two of the bloodiest battles in the Pacific.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it was really quite amazing. And so she was first on a hospital ship, and so she took a lot of photos of the wounded, and it really influenced her, I think, her work for the rest of her career.
Yeah, she actually brought that visual back here to the States for people to see, right?
Yes, absolutely. And obviously, she worked for a number of different publications during the course of her time. She had stories in Reader's Digest and National Geographic. But she was from Milwaukee, so she was from Wisconsin. And in fact, there's an archive of Dickie Chappelle's work at the Wisconsin Historical Society. So there's 23,000 photographic images, and she was a pack rat, so there are tons of things that she had written, her reporter's notebooks, drafts for stories, and grocery lists and things like that. So it's really quite a large collection that still exists today.
Now, because of all of her accomplishments, Governor Walker has a proclamation that honors not just her, but other journalists as well.
Yes, that's true. Dickie Chappelle was the first female war correspondent killed in action, but it's not common. Covering war is a dangerous business, and certainly James Foley, who was a Marquette graduate, is one of the other noteworthy ones that come to mind. And so, really, she happens to be representative of all war correspondents, including a few of the other folks from Wisconsin.
Now, talk about this special book talk that's going to be happening, as well as a signing.
Well, there are two things coming up. I'm going to be at the Sterling North Edgerton Book Festival on Saturday, tonight I'm going to be at the Barnes & Noble in West Madison. So we'll have an opportunity to talk about Dickie Chappelle, and hopefully people will see some more of her photographic works and things. So I'm looking forward to that.
Well, thanks so much for being with us. And again, this is a great book. I encourage everybody to thumb through it and enjoy it as well. Stay with us. We have a final check of your traffic and weather right after this.